Preach Craig, as I like to call him, Craig Garland, comes prays with me before every run. Well, Grubby will be on a mission, walking back from the starting line to the tow vehicle. Not to talk to me, to talk to Doug. And so Craig is literally grabbing my hand, and we're about to pray. And I'm like, wait a minute. I don't normally tell the preacher, wait a minute, but I'm like, shh. So I just said, wait a minute. And so we're trying to listen to what Grubby's telling Doug. And he says, boss, I think there's a 366 out there, but I'm not sure what else there is. But I see a 366. I think that'll be the best. And so Craig's looking at me. Preacher Craig's looking at me like, and so I text on my phone. I didn't send it to nobody, but I text on my phone. Grubby said 366.
More fun to sit back and kind of just watch my team work, and you know what they're up against. You know, when the conditions are like this, you know, no one's really talking, but they're focused on what they're doing, and they're trying to make record run. And you know, we were pushing it tonight to run better than 83 and try to run 340 miles an hour because the conditions were out there. But it didn't work out. It's like, it's one of those things where there's so many components on one of these nitro cars that just have to work in sync with each other.
We expected, everybody was asking me before the run, and I thought, you know, with the sun going down like it went, it hit in a hurry there, and you could lick your chops when that happened. You stand on it. You know, the conditions, the weather, the atmospheric conditions didn't change that much from the first run to the second run, but just the sun coming off the racetrack, that makes the racetrack all you can handle. And you know, we worked together some with Lanny McGleasy, that's the track guru out there, the track whisperer, and he basically was out there with his traction machine, and he had to quit doing it or he was going to snap the thing off.
That last run, that was you know, not what we were looking for to cap off our number one qualifying effort on the first session. It was on a decent pass. It wouldn't have gone any quicker than I did in the first run, but I'm not sure if track prep wasn't 100% down there. Both our Harleys did the same thing. Got to 1,000 foot, and next thing I know I'm going straight down the track, and next thing I'm staring at the wall right at the finish line. So it... Yeah, I should have been going about 185 miles an hour past the 1,000-foot cones, and the rear tire was going about 205. It was up bouncing off the limiter at 11,000 RPM, and something that isn't comforting by any means.